In this video, I'm going to show you the reason why you might have to consider two biodigesters, that's biofuel biodigesters, for your property, even though it is a standard family house, as in it's a 3 or 4 bedroom and even a 2 bedroom house. Biodigesters can serve a lot of purposes. One of them is that it doesn't matter the amount of users sometimes, and it doesn't also matter the kind of building. But what we have done over the years with the experience we've had is to design the digesters to fit for purpose. What we mean by this is that we do the digesters based on the number of rooms and how many toilets are in the house. So if you come to your place and we realize you have a 3 bedroom house, let's consider a 3 or 4 bedroom house, and there are 4 seats in the house, what we do is usually to tell you to do one biodigester. But there are exceptions to that, and there could be a certain scenario or a certain case in which you have to consider doing 2 biodigesters. I'm at a property right now here in Accra, and I'm going to show you why you might have to consider doing 2 biodigesters instead of one. And if in case an installer should tell you you might consider 2 biodigesters, there could be a reason why you have to consider that. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing, hit the bell notification, and watch videos like this that we do for those who are interested in installing biodigester and knowing all about this new amazing technology. We are also on Instagram and Facebook at Dreamhouse Biodigesters. Let's go around and I'll show you the reason why you might have to consider doing 2 biodigesters for your standard family property. This is a 4 bedroom house and suite, self-contained, with each room having its own toilet and a guest toilet outside. Now we are here to install a biodigester, and what we had to tell the client was that she will need to do 2 biodigesters. She was surprised at first, but then she came to realize that it makes a lot of sense, and I'm going to show you why. This one toilet is up here. That's the one there. And there's another one here, which is way down there. There's a slope. I mean, we are on a hilltop, so there's a slope. So it's going to work fine. If only it was going into a manhole, because then we can get a longer depth. And then no matter how far the pipe is and where it's coming from, if it's 10 feet and you are even using 4 feet or 2.5 or 3 feet for burying the pipe into the septic tank, then it works fine, it works well. But with a biodigester, which is about 2 feet or 2.5 feet, you cannot let the pipes be running around the house. There's going to be a problem tomorrow for us and for you, the homeowner. And the needed peace of mind that you are looking for, you might not get. So that's why we ask now that if you are constructing your house or you are planning the construction of a house and you intend to use a biodigester, you might consider it at the beginning and see where you are going to place it. You have to consider doing 2 biodigesters. It doesn't mean that somebody is trying to take advantage of you. It only means that the work has to be done in such a way that the digester will have its service purpose, and then the homeowner will also have their peace of mind. Biodigester here just to serve this part of the house. There's a lot of slope in this house, and the slope goes all the way to the down there. Now let me show you something. So let's say you are doing a pipe connection into a septic tank, a biodigester. It means you have to run it all the way here and come to the lowest point. Meanwhile, there's no toilet here again. The next available toilet in this building is all the way down there where the slope goes. So why would you consider running a pipe all the way here? One pipe at the top. When we are going, you have to come before you see another toilet here. I think that this is the master bedroom. Then you see another toilet here, right? Just to serve this. And then it still runs all the way. So the other one is at the front. The guest run is there, and there's another 2 at the other side. So you can't run all these ones all the way here if you are doing a one by digester. There's going to be a problem because then some of the pipes might get wound up, and then it might cause the pipes to fall at the base of the digester. If you are going to use a septic tank, there's not going to be a problem. You can come and perforate them at different size of the septic tank, and then you can drop them in. The depth of the manhole is about 10 feet. So no matter the situation and where you find yourself, your pipe will always come. But here is the case, you realize there's a better option. And the better option is the bio digester, the biofuel bio digester. But you can't consider doing only one, because if you do one, the pipes that are coming from the back will not come inside. They will come and fall at the base of the digester. The depth of the digester is only 2 feet. In a worst case scenario, you might decide to put it on some blocks just to elevate it small for the pipe to come. So if I'm doing my inlet here, it means I have basically 1.5 feet to work with. And that's not what you want when the pipe is coming all the way from the back. You want everything to come and fall in. So then the option is to do 2 bio digesters and then divide the toilets in the house into 2. So if it's 5 toilets, 3 will go into 1, and then 2 will go into 1. If it's 4 bedroom house and it's only 4 toilets and they are scattered all over the house, they are in different parts of the building, then you also have to consider doing 2 separate ones, because you cannot line all of them on the same part of the house. But I guess this, as you can see, it's not really a big thing. They are not big. They are supposed to work in such a way that the water doesn't stay in. Rapid separation allows for the water to go away, only for the solid waste to stay inside for microorganisms to work on them. So it does not need a lot of activity in terms of how pipes are coming, whether they're not coming. You want to do a digester, do the simplest pipe connection as much as possible into the digester. If in case there's a problem tomorrow, you know where to locate it. But if the slope is not there, the drainage is not there, and they are scattered, it's better to divide the toilets in the house into 2 and do a digester for each of them. Your cost might go up, but it does not negate the fact that you are doing a good job for a long-term effect. You want your job to last. You want the homeowner to have their peace of mind, and then everybody must be on the same page. That's the reason why we consider doing 2 bio digesters instead of just doing 1 for some properties. This does not apply to all properties. If you are building a new house, or you are designing a new house and you are going to consider installing a bio digester, you might as well put it in mind and start from there, knowing the positioning of where you are going to put the digester. You don't want to finish the work or get to a point before you consider where the toilet is going to be. It's a critical part of every building. So if you're going to install a bio digester, make sure it becomes part of it, so that your cost does not go up later when you are told or when you are forced to do 2 bio digesters because you did not consider it at the beginning of the building. That's the main reason why some people or some of the installers will ask you to do 2 bio digesters. Some even ask you to do 3. It's not because probably they are trying to take advantage of you or anything of that sort, but it's because of the situation that they find themselves. You also don't want to do the job and then in the end you realize that it's not done well and the pipe has fallen at the base because it's coming from a long far away, and knowing the depth of the digester is only 2.5 feet, it's possible it might come and fall at the base, and the gradient that has been picked or the slope that has been picked is not well, then there's going to be a problem tomorrow, because either the tissue or solid waste will come and block the end of the toilet and it might not work well for you. So consider all these things when you are planning your house and then you want to install a bio digester as part of it. If you are going to consider your septic tank as part of the system, then obviously this video is not for you, because your septic tank will work well even when it's 10 feet and it's 15 feet. No matter where the pipes are and where the washrooms are, they will always come and fall in nicely for you. But when you're doing a bio digester, you have to consider all these things. Of course, there are some cases and some situations where people go into some properties because they're looking at making some quick bucks. They just tell you, no matter the situation, you have to do 2 or 3 bio digesters. Some even insist on you doing a digester for each toilet in the house. How is that possible? I mean, what kind of mindset is that? It's really not the issue. The issue is the piping and the toilet seats and the location where they have been located and how to make sure that you get a good job done in terms of the slope and the gradient. Not necessarily the amount of money you are going to make, but the peace of mind that you are going to give the homeowner. That's key when it comes to buy the addresses, because it's a new product and most people do not believe in it. So you must well do the best thing that puts everybody on the same page. If you go, you do your job and the homeowner says, no, I don't have the amount of money to do two or three biodigesters, it's best for you either to walk or to just say, well, that's the best I can do, but not necessary to consider, because you're also looking at the money, and then you go and do one digester and then tomorrow there's a problem and everybody is saying, biodigesters do not work. That's not what we want in this industry. Thank you so much for watching this video. Subscribe to this channel if you are new here, and watch all the other videos that we have. Thank you. Next time. Bye-bye.